Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asian Newsland, and here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 22nd of August. Poland-India relations bolsters as PM Modi holds talk with counterpart Tusk, honors fallen heroes. At least 20,000 people affected due to heavy monsoon rains in eastern Bangladesh. And Lankan President Wickremesinghe questions feasibility of IMF renegotiations. And now for all the news. Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Thursday held delegation-level talks with his Polish counterpart Donald Tusk, discussing avenues of mutual interest during his official visit to the Central European country. Before the meeting, PM Modi received a grand ceremonial welcome at the Chancellery in Warsaw in the presence of the Polish Prime Minister. He also led a wreath at the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier in Warsaw. Earlier, addressing the Indian diaspora in the Polish capital on Wednesday, Prime Minister Modi said India is the mother of democracy and emphasized that shared values with Poland bring the two countries closer. He also praised the Polish government's assistance during Operation Ganga, India's mission to evacuate its citizens during the Russia-Ukraine conflict.
Ukraine mein phase hamare bachchon ki madad ki वो भी हम सभी ने देखा है। आपने उनकी बहुत सेवा की थी। आपने लंगर लगाए, आपने अपने घर के दरवाजे खोले, अपने रेस्तरां खोल दिए। पोलैंड की सरकार ने तो वीजा जैसे बंधनों को भी हमारे स्टूडेंट्स के लिए हटा दिया था। यानी पोलैंड ने पूरे मन से हमारे बच्चों के लिए दरवाजे खोल दिए थे।
In the second and final leg of his visit to Central European countries, the Indian Prime Minister is scheduled to visit Ukraine later in the day at the invitation of Ukraine President Volodymyr Zelensky. This will be the first visit by an Indian Prime Minister to Ukraine since bilateral relations began in 1992. Ahead of his visit to Kyiv, the Indian Prime Minister emphasized that India has always advocated for permanent peace in the region and believes in dialogue and diplomacy to resolve conflicts. Amid strong protests by doctors demanding justice for the 31-year-old trainee doctor who was brutally raped and murdered in India's Kolkata city, the Supreme Court on Thursday assured the protesters that no adverse action would be taken against them and urged them to return back to work. The apex court criticized the role of the state police and questioned the role of former principal of the institution, Sandeep Kumar Ghosh, and said it seems there was an attempt to pass off the murder as a suicide. Meanwhile, protests continued across India as the incident in Kolkata has triggered demands for justice for the victim and greater safety for women at hospitals, with doctors in several places refusing to see non-emergency patients. The public anger and protest over violence against women is reminiscent of what followed the gang rape and murder of a 23-year-old student on a bus in New Delhi in 2012. Pakistan is making good progress with the International Monetary Fund IMF and hopes to secure board approval in September for a new $7 billion loan program, Pakistan's Finance Minister Mohammad Aurangzeb said on Wednesday. Pakistan and the IMF reached an agreement on the 37-month loan program in July. However, the global lender stated that the program was subject to approval from its executive board and the timely confirmation of necessary financing assurances from Pakistan's development and bilateral partners. Islamabad is in talks with bilateral creditors including Saudi Arabia, the United Arab Emirates and China to meet the gross financing needs under the IMF program. Rollovers or disbursements on loans from Pakistan's long-term allies in addition to financing from the IMF have helped Pakistan meet its external financing needs in the past. However, the latest agreement with the IMF includes tough measures such as raising taxes on farm income, emphasizing the need to boost government revenue and reduce the fiscal deficit. This has raised concerns among poor and middle-class Pakistanis who are already contending with the threat of further inflation in the country.
बहुत रो रहे, बल्कि गरीब हो चुके हैं, कुछ इनके पास नहीं है खाने के लिए नहीं है, और इन लोग की आंखों में मिट्टी है। जो बड़े बड़े बैठे हुए वो बोलते हैं खाली बस हमको पैसा आने दो, बाहर का गवर्नमेंट में जाओ, वो लोग 15 साल से लेकर जो है ना 18 साल तक सारा गवर्नमेंट खर्चा, बच्चों का, लेडीजों का खर्चा उठा रहे, ये तो बोलते हैं हमको दो, बोलते ऐसा वक्त आएगा कि बोलेगा बच्चे पैदा करेगा उसका भी टैक्स दो भाई, फिर ऐसा टाइम भी आएगा लोग बोलेगा कि बात करेगा उसका भी टैक्स दो। हम लोग तो डर रहे कि पता नहीं आगे आगे वो क्या क्या सीन होएगा।
As Afghanistan battles severe humanitarian crisis, World Food Programme on Wednesday distributed cash to 371 vulnerable Afghan citizens in Kabul. The WFP started its cash distribution programme in a bid to help reduce poverty in the country. Some citizens appreciated the donation, while some say this is the first time they received the aid, but they cannot even buy a sack of flour through it. Afghanistan has been ruled by the Taliban for the last 3 years following the withdrawal of foreign forces. Since seizing power, Taliban has been imposing severe restrictions on women and have banned them from attending schools beyond 6th grade and have also barred them from public spaces.
Hi, this is Khuda Pak de Khur Sawkata Syrian Biryan Zaman Mitul Pukurnosti. And we zipe nashtadi. نو په دوه شرایط کې دا کومک ماته ډېر ښه دی، په خپله حیاتي ګڼم د ستنې کار کوم، خو ماته دغه هم غلیمت دی که نه مې دوا کي او نه مې ښه شی کي، خو بیا هم ماته ښه دی، دغه هم شکرګزاره مننه د دولت نه چې دغه کومک کوم شکر دی
چې بېخي موږ اقتصاد خرابه ده، سړی په کور ناسته بېکاره ده، بیا هغه وینیم دغه اولین دفعه ده زه بنده کومک یې نیولی یم، اوس د زړه نلکې شوش نلکې مې بندې دي، دا درې زره خو ما نه اولاد مې ده، خو وړم نه کېږي دا خو.
Heavy monsoon rains triggering flash floods in Bangladesh eastern region has affected at least 20,000 people. Komila and Feni districts were seen submerged in water, whereas in Feni district, residents were evacuating with their belongings by boats and other makeshift transportation. Reports suggest that 4 people have lost their lives in the floods. Bangladesh blamed that the current situation was caused by release of waters from India-Tripura's Dumbur Dam. However, India has refuted the allegations and called it factually incorrect. India further went on to say that floods on the common rivers between both the countries were a shared problem inflicting sufferings on people on both sides and required close mutual cooperation towards resolving them. Sri Lankan President Ranil Wickremesinghe on Thursday defended the debt negotiation framework with international creditors and questioned the feasibility of renegotiating the established benchmarks and timelines as suggested by the opposition parties. Both parties, which are contesting against Wickremesinghe in September 21st presidential election, has claimed the existing IMF program will be revisited and renegotiated. Questioning the claims, Wickremesinghe said it took the current administration 1 year to finalize the current mechanism, as he emphasized the intricate coordination required in the process. What are they going to renegotiate? Are they renegotiating the benchmarks? What else are they going to renegotiate? Are they going to renegotiate the time span? Or are they going to renegotiate the benchmarks? He was quoted as saying by Lankan media outlet News First. Sri Lanka will hold a presidential poll on September 21st, with the Election Commission giving approval for President Ranil Wickremesinghe to contest in the race that will pit him against opposition leader Sajith Premadasa and Marxist-leaning parliamentarian Anuragkumara Dissanayake. The winner will have to shore up the fragile economic recovery, implement more taxes under the IMF program, finalize a $12.5 billion debt restructuring and focus on achieving sustainable growth. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night and take care.
Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.